Dear Lord, please watch over us as we walk through this forest that you created in the pursuit of big game, which you also created. If we happen upon some of this big game that you created and let an arrow fly, please let it fly true and fast and find its mark. Please let the animal expire as quickly as possible. In your name we pray. Amen.
Wow, it's the opening day of bear season here. Me and Dad just made it in the stand. He's all set up and ready. Thank you.
Well, it's hunt day number two. As you guys seen yesterday, we had the big bear we were after come in, but he wouldn't present a shot. So that's a bummer. And then we had a strong west wind come in for some reason, and he winded us. And then he just walked off. So we're gonna hunt the same set today. And hopefully he wants to show himself again. The wind we got today should be better for it. Or it shouldn't be as swirly or weird. Just some weird west wind come out of nowhere. But then we also had that small bear. He was in there like all night. But too small to shoot. So right now we're just baiting our other two spots. We just got done baiting one of them. And then we got one more to bait. And then we'll be right back in the tree. So we'll see ya when we're in the tree.
just seen that bigger sow and that little sow. The badger very wary yesterday because it's very quiet, so every little noise made them react or twitch. But today we're at bait site number one, right down there. And we've came to the conclusion that the next decent bear, or shooter-sized bear, is going down because my truck is broken. It's having electrical issues and suspension issues. His truck, the oil pump's failing. So we're kind of don't really have trucks to run up here. And we're also 8 hours from home, so something goes wrong, it's not good. And a lot of our spots are way back on these forest roads. I don't know if a tow truck would come get us. So we've decided the next shooter bear is going down. So we'll see ya when we get some action in the stand. Minnesota black bear. It's a giant. That's a fucking booner, baby.
That's a big one.
We got blue. We've had this bear on trail cam since the third day that we were here. So today is day 18. So we've had this bear on this bait for 15 days now. It's been coming in consistently at 6 to 6:30. And then what time is it?
Right now, 6:37.
Yeah, baby. So it's still consistent. We're shaking. That shot, I knew it felt perfect. It felt perfect. We heard the death moan. We know.
I caught my first Minnesota black bear. Redemption, baby. I was here 3-4 years ago. I had an encounter with a bear. I never got it. Well, I'm back and we made it happen. DIY, baby. Who needs a guide? We finally made it happen. And it's a big one. One of the biggest bears I've ever seen, man. It's big. So, it's a perfect time for it to happen, too. We got about half a barrel of bait left. Both our trucks are about done. We're going to have to limp them home. It paid off. I was getting worried there. It was on day number 4 and we weren't seeing anything.
Oh my goodness. Giant.
So, we're going to go get all the recovery stuff in front of the truck.
Yeah.
Then we'll see ya when we're on the blood trail. I think it only went like 50 yards, so it's pretty close. So we'll see ya then.
Well, we shot him up there, about 10 yards. We're trying to track the crap like this, all mud and moss, but it's been raining for the last 8 hours, so it's hard to see. Dad was walking up here on the trail that it came in on.
Man, what do we got there, guys? And we found him.
Dad spotted.
Found him. Old Blue.
Found the bear. There we go. Just a giant. Well, we just made it back to camp. Sorry we didn't show you much of the bear, but here's the bear right there. As you guys can see, got it in the truck, back to camp. That was a lot of hard work. We had to go about like 200 yards with it. We had to end up cutting the bear in half because we tried the stretcher method. Well, it was too heavy that it broke the stretcher the first time.
Yeah. Well, and by the way, give credit where credit is due. Thank you, Dan Infault, for that idea.
Thank you, Dan Infault. But yeah, it broke the first time. Second time, we couldn't even lift it. It's too heavy. So we ended up skinning it up, cutting it in half, and then hauling half out, other half later. But we got it all done. We got it here. Gonna finish skinning it, quarter it out. Get it all in the coolers with ice on it. Then should be done with that about 2 a.m. Then we're waking up bright and early at about 6:30, 7, getting the trailers loaded, going to get all the cameras and signs and everything we left at the bait sites, and gonna get all that done and drive home, and then off to scouting whitetails in our normal territory. This is, this forest stuff is a lot different to us. We're used to field and prairie, so.
Yeah, we're used to the flatland.
So. Yep. So, who knows? We even might be able to make it for the last day of early teal if we get back soon enough and maybe be able to film some of that, but. Yep, 4 days it took. 4 days. 2 broken trucks, 18 days up here, and 4.5 barrels of bait. So it was all worth it. Hard work, but hard work pays off. I mean, I'd rather work hard for something and get it instead of not work at all and get it. It feels more of an accomplishment, and I actually did stuff. Like, this pays off for our work, but... Yep, thank you to this bear's life. It gave us an awesome adventure and a fun time, good memories, and thank you to the Lord for giving us the opportunity to do this and giving us these creatures to hunt and letting us be able to get it out of the woods and get everything done with minimal injuries. So thank you guys for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed, and we'll see you on the next one. Peace.